Hey guys, it's Phoenix. Crocodiles in Minecraft. This is using something which first came to my mind as soon as I saw it, and it's evoker fangs, which I don't think a lot of people talk about. In fact, Woodland Mansions has sort of flown underneath the radar ever since they were first introduced. And I'm not sure why, perhaps it hasn't really seen any practical worth in Minecraft, but here is something that you can add to any Minecraft survival experience. And let me just show you guys what I did. So I'm going to swim across the swamp, which I've just imported into my test world. And as soon as I do so, so dangerous waters, of course, and I'm just going to press F5. You can see some teeth trying to chomp me up. And it's going to keep on doing that if I keep swimming in the water. So I need to find some land. Let's just do it one more time. There we go. And I should be safe now. Okay, so it's not actually crocodiles, but in a sense it is, because, well, it's almost like fish in Minecraft. You don't really see it as a mob, but you can fish them out. So they exist in some form or shape. This adds some value as well, because you can create challenges like parkour challenges. And if you fail and you fall off, you will die because a crocodile will eat you up. It just gives you a bit more risk and danger. So there are only 5 command blocks you need to add here. Unfortunately, 1.13 is coming out relatively soon, so this concept will be redundant as that comes out. Now, of course, I know a lot of you guys probably won't be updating 1.13 because it's almost meaningless, because it doesn't give any new feature. So maybe you guys are going to stick with this one. But anyway, that's why the command concepts have been sparse recently. But anyway, if you guys would like to see how this works, you basically just need to add a dummy objective. I'm not using stat.swim1cm, and that's because I want to be able to detect when the player is simply floating in the water. So that's how you do it. So execute at P, again, this stuff is going to change to offset at as stuff like that. So detecting when the player is on water, on their own Y level, and it's going to add a swim objective value by 1. So their score is going to iterate. So as soon as it reaches 100, so execute at P swim 100 for a minimum value, it's going to summon evocation fangs, which I know is an entity that many of you haven't thought about. But this is so useful because it's an entity that simply disappears as soon as it's summoned. And this has a lot of map making power to it. So it's I'm using it here just to create a crocodile attacking you. As soon as that happens, their swim score gets set back to 0, and when you're off the off water, so you're back on land, the it goes back to 0. So this is a very fun way for you to manipulate as well, because if you want the fangs to be summoned almost instantly, you can set this to 10, and if I fail the parkour, let's go back here, because I made a simple parkour, which I'm terrible at, but here's a demonstration of my technique, my prowess. So here we go. I failed it. And I get caught immediately. It says got killed by magic, and that's because it's summoned by the evoker, the illager. So you can change that if you want. But regardless, I think this is a very fun concept you can play around with, adds a bit more spice to your survival experience, and here is how you do it. Of course, this will change 1.13. Thank you for watching. Leave a like, subscribe for more creative content like this. Take care.